Summer's.
Is it sleep time or something?
No.
Do you want to come to me, will he? Don't use your tummy.
How's James?
No, it's good, I said. Sorry, Erica. I just sort of wanted to take some photos and Facebook if people can remember. Well, that was terrible.
Not the gun. You didn't have to take a chin, which would be
very. Brothers? But, and I also remember that in our old place in Smithfield Road in Whanganui, down the end was the kitchen was an old wood-fired stove, an old Orion. Now I'd stoked that up one morning, and I didn't understand, I didn't remember, or I didn't check, that there was a pan left in the oven from the roast dinner the night before. And soon enough, as I was stoking the fire, because we needed to get the water hot for baths and showers and washes in the morning for 8 children, which is a lot, and it means a lot of wood and a lot of heat, the stove began to smoke. Anyway, I was really worried about that, and I didn't dare open the stove because I knew what would happen. It would burst into flame, and it didn't. But there was Valerie, and Valerie, of course, in her usual way, sort of the situation. The stove was cooled down a bit. Everybody was whatever, and we were on our way. I used to hate that job, first thing in the morning, because the other thing it would do, it would make me late for school occasionally. And at Whanganui Tech, and this is a real double jeopardy thing, which I was thinking about, and I think this is so unfair, that if you were late for school, you got a detention. And if you were late for school 3 times in a term, you had to go to a committee meeting of all the teachers and all the counsellors and all the prefects. And if you got 3 detentions in a term, you then received 6 blows of the cane. So it was a double jeopardy, you know. And it wasn't my fault. You know, I couldn't help it if they would get on the way and go to school at home. So, and I always knew when it was that I was late because the 9 o'clock pips on the radio would go, and I knew that I'm in trouble. And there was always one prefect or councillor that was there that was doing the cycle patrol. And as soon as I turned up in the morning, there he was. And Councillor Borry, who I understand is now a lawyer in Whanganui, was there to issue me with the appropriate detention. So you've got a detention which means you have to pay your time. And secondly, you then have to attend this councillor's meeting, for which the result was inevitable. And there was no one to stand up. Even in the Navy, we had the accused friend, and who used to give a statement of mitigation about why it was that this offence occurred. And so you get, well, not get away with it, but it would temper the situation a little. Never mind. Right, moving right along. Not so long ago, in Wellington, we attended.
All I remember is knocking on this door, 56 Papanui Street.
That was right.
And I said to my brother, hey, Ron, geez, Carl's parents, pretty posh. mother talks like she's been to Oxford or somewhere. It was a brand new HU Holton station wagon up the drive, and the father looks a bit well-to-do as well. Sorry, Bob, you've gone downhill, mate. But anyway, time went by, and I was a little bit cheeky, evidently, I'm told, but I never got too many growlings or anything along the way. But earlier on today, I got told I wasn't to talk about vacuum cleaners, so this has handicapped me a little bit. So all I can say is it's a credit, actually, to see Val still the same person that I first bumped into all those years ago to what I see today. A little bit more in common with Melville Payhoof, possibly. She's still the same person. But a few years ago, I came across something I didn't really know. Actually, I don't know if anybody in the room knows, but Bob was applying for a passport or something. One of them was signing these papers, so he dropped them up home and reading through. And I said to Bob, I've got to ring Bob up. Something like that. Ring him up. I said, is Val out of earshot? Because, you know, my eyes might be gone, but the ears are still pretty sharp. And I said to him, no wonder you're always tired when I see you. This is Bird Muriel on this form here. And he said that, and there was a hesitation, you know, when people hesitate, they sound a bit guilty about something. And he said, no, that's Val. I said, so Val is Muriel. And he said, yes. I said, oh, thank Christ for that. Got over that hurdle, and time went by. Anyway, about two years ago, when did we do the South Island, mate? It was 2 years ago. Anyway, we got a chance to go down to Fiordland, and it turned out Val had never been there, and we have a...
But when I say really, the bottom of my heart, it's given me great pleasure to be able to be, or have you all here. And it just blows me away, really, the mere fact that we have this family, and it's part of all of us in every small way. But as for the remarks from Ross and John, you'll keep. I thank you.
Yeah. Valerie from the heart.
As well. Yeah. Does my heart work. I guess turning 80 for me, I thought, was quite a milestone, really.
Better than my 21st,
though. It took a long time to get there. That's all I can say. I sort of thought, denied and wondered about the whole thing, but I'm pleased that it's happened and that we're all able to get there, get together. And it's just so important. Family's about the best thing that you could ever have. You know, without the backbone of all the rest of it that goes with it. I know that a lot of you have travelled some distance, and for that I'm very grateful. And I do wish you a safe journey. Whether you're in an aeroplane or a car or a bus, whatever be. And as for John, he blotted his copybook back years ago when he arrived at my place with a rat around his neck. That was his pet hamster. So he'd come in one door and I went out the other door. That's one thing I can't. Another time he blotted his copybook was we were sitting down for a roast dinner with the boys that asked me to put a staple to. Yes, that's fine. And we were sitting down there and he asked me for tomato sauce. It surprises me he's still around today. Chris, thanks, Audrey. You're great to help. Thank you. I'm getting slightly emotional now.
I think everybody's behaved themselves quite well this afternoon. We've all said and done the right thing. And so I think we will start with the...